afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to Stanford University. We're here at the 2014 Junior Olympics, and we're here for the 14 and under boys gold medal championship match here in the championship tournament platinum division, along with Caltech head coach Pat Beamer, Greg Meskel here with you poolside at Stanford. And don't adjust your computer. This is Vanguard playing again. The Vanguard club has made the finals of the 12, 14, and 16 U boys. They're taking on Sleepy Hollow Aquatics, a.k.a. SHAQ, and we're underway here with the opening sprint of Vanguard in the white caps, SHAQ in the dark, as we get things started here in this one between Vanguard and SHAQ. And if you watched our last game, it was a thrilling finish for Vanguard, winning that one 12-11, as they're able to sneak past SoCal there for the championship victory.
I like what SHAQ did right off the opening sprint. I don't know if you caught that there, Greg, but Spencer Hansen, number three, just went wire to wire underwater, hoping for the win of the sprint to get a quick goal.
I know you're a fan of the underwater play.
Done it more than once.
Here's SHAQ now. They're led by their head coach, Matt Swanson, former UCLA goalkeeper. Looking to try and go inside. Shot clock to three. They'll get the lob. They'll get the score. And SHAQ is on the board with Connor Moynihan delivering.
Yeah, Moynihan, that was a great adjustment on his shot. He legged out and away, and he noticed that the Vanguard keeper, Noah Hodge, who's off his line just enough, puts it up and over. This is a polar opposite start from the Vanguard 12 and unders.
Vanguard 12 and unders went ahead 3-0 before SoCal could muster a goal. So here they find themselves on the other end of things, down 1-0. Quick outside try, and that one's field blocked and knocked down.
So clearly SHAQ has game plan to deny Vanguard down at 2 meters. They played what we've seen a lot of this weekend, the M drop. And Vanguard's going to be happy to press, especially when you've got length like that. Quinn Simpson seems to be 7 foot playing against 5 footers.
Yeah, just came over a long arm there. Able to take it away, and now Vanguard back on the attack. Just underway here in the first, now into the 14U division. We play 7 minute quarters. 5:17 to go here in the first. Big outside shot from Ash Moulton. And that one is blocked out on the field block, and it'll come back to SHAQ.
I think Vanguard is going to have to be a little more patient with their offense there. I know Ash Moulton's got a huge arm and isn't afraid to use it, but the chance so early in the clock was not going to bode well.
Entry inside, working inside 2 meters, ordinary called. And they'll pull it back out. Outside try, and that shot attempt over the goal line of play on the attempt from Emerson Sullivan. And now we'll get things restarted here. 4:39 to go in the first. 1-0 lead for SHAQ over Vanguard.
Now Vanguard, check that. SHAQ has switched to the man zone, and now they drop back.
Outside attempt there, and deflected. But knocked out, it'll come back into 2 meters, rolling there with the stop, and 2 meters is where the ball will go for Vanguard.
Gonna have a quick timeout for a cap adjustment.
Vanguard on the attack. Moulton takes a look. Simpson, they play catch on the perimeter. Shot clock to 13 for Vanguard. 4 minutes to play in the first.
Deep shot coming.
And that one wide left of the goal out of play. And Sleepy Hollow will take over. Entry inside. Big turn, but good defense from behind. Jacob Cavano coming over to make that knockaway as Woodhead was trying to work inside 2 meters.
Yeah, it was good stair-step help there. but so far both teams kind of look slow in transition. Am I crazy about that?
No, it does seem to be a little bit of a slower pace early. Here's a wheel inside, and an exclusion will be called. This will go against Shaq. And here's a power play. Quick shot, bar down, and out. Dug out of there by Roland.
Wow, that's just unlucky there. What a great shot. Couldn't quite finish. Floated on the goal line for a second, and Roland able to steal it away.
Now here's Michael Dacus on the move. Pulls it back out on the perimeter to Moss. Shot clock to 7 for Sleepy Hollow. Under 3 to play in the first quarter. That attempt's over the goal. So we saw the one exclusion down there, but we're not seeing much generated around 2 meters. These teams contend to try and fire from the perimeter.
Yeah, and both squads are showing some form of a drop or a help defense on a 2 meters. They clearly want to neutralize that game for each other. And they're going to have to find a way, whether it's with motion or the early entry, to use 2 meters how they want.
There's Vanguard. Moulton from deep puts it away. We're tied at 1 as Moulton's on the board, and so is Vanguard to even things up here with 2:22 to go in the first.
I'll tell you what, a kid with the caliber of Ash Moulton, if you're giving him that kind of space on the perimeter, bad things are going to happen to you. That lefty just legged up, buried it upper 90 cross cage. Shaq is going to probably make an adjustment there.
Moulton rising within the men's youth national team and the national team pipeline in general. And the ball's knocked away. Still a scramble for it. Lob try over the goal on the attempt there from Dacus. Under 2 to play here in the first. We're even at 1. Vanguard and Shaq playing for the 14U gold medal.
I'm wondering if that's something that they saw in the scouting report.
Outside attempt there. Knockdown Roland in trouble way out of the goal. And he is excluded for his efforts. So now they'll have to pack the cage here. 6-on-5, but the goalie is out, as Daniel Roland is excluded for Sleepy Hollow. It'll take time to fix a cap so three field players can figure out what they want to do for Sleepy Hollow in the cage.
Yeah, whenever you see a goalkeeper having to play some semblance of perimeter defense, it generally results in bad news.
Now remember, field players in the goal can only use one hand, so you're seeing the three guys in the cage with just one arm up only. And a shot attempt there is off the mark. The rebound field blocked and rebounded by Sleepy Hollow. And they get out of a difficult situation with field players in the cage controlling the defense.
That is such a huge stop. Moulton shot just goes off the bar, falls luckily into the outstretched arms, and then an even better field block.
Now here's Sleepy Hollow on the attack. 1:14 to play. First quarter, we're tied at 1. Entry inside. Moynihan working inside. He has the 1 goal thus far, but a contra foul there is the call. And it comes back to Noah Hodge, the Vanguard keeper.
And that's something that a young center is going to have to learn. I mean, Moynihan had good position there and just got a little too aggressive to hold the position that, frankly, he didn't need to.
Less than a minute to play here in the first. Here's an opportunity for Vanguard from the outside. Quick release from Cavano. But it's off the mark, and it's tracked down by Sleepy Hollow. 39 seconds to play in the first. We're tied at 1. Live here on CoachesAid.com. Thanks for joining us. We'll have our 16U and 18U boys gold medal finals to follow here.
You know, so strange, Greg, because Sleepy Hollow does have the advantage in this game. They're up 1-0, but their offense just looks really disorganized right now.
There's Vanguard on the move. Here's Cavano. Just 3 seconds left. Shot clock is off. Catch and release. It's tipped out with just 1 second remaining, as Roland got a fingertip on that one. So it'll come back in for Vanguard. but they're not going to get a shot off in time. And we come to the end of the first. A good one here between Vanguard and Sleepy Hollow Aquatics in our 14U championship. We're all even at one. We'll take a timeout and return. Stay with us here on CoachesAid.com. In the water, and we're underway to start off the second, and Sleepy Hollow controls things here to start off our second period.
I'm curious to see what sort of quarter adjustments were made by both squads. I mentioned before, Shaq's offense looked a little disorganized, but even on the opposite end, Vanguard wasn't doing what a lot of Vanguards do, bang the ball in the middle and look to shoot from the perimeter.
Entry inside, a little soft on that one, needed more on that pass, and an easy takeaway for Vanguard as Wyatt Benson comes over to make that steal. Here's Moulton. Swings to Watson. They move it around the perimeter to start off their first possession here of the second quarter. Double post opportunity there. Can't get it inside. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Quick shot, and again, one almost trickled past Roland, but he's able to keep that one out of the goal. Banged off the post there a bit, and now a long outlet pass. He finds Dacus in transition. Puts on the brakes, tries the lob. That one's swatted back. Matumboed out of there by Noah Hodge, and it'll stay with Shaq and a new shot clock.
That's the third lob attempt in this game so far by Shaq, something that is really more of a situational shot. Yep.
And now an exclusion drawn by Connor Moynihan. That'll be Watson going out. Big turn there from Moynihan, able to draw that exclusion.
Goals have come at a premium thus far. Golden opportunity here for Shaq. See if they can capitalize.
A few fakes, score it. Bar in. Wyatt Hansen delivering from the outside. Shaq goes ahead, 2-1.
That was a pretty high-level shot that Hansen just made there. Up on his legs, held it for 3-4 hezzy fakes, and was able to wrap around the blocking defender, wrap around the goalkeeper, and bang it home cross cage.
Nicely done, and a 2-1 lead here for Sleepy Hollow. Here's Vanguard. They give to Moulton on the outside. Keep it on the perimeter. Outside attempt and a rope from distance. Score it for Jacob Cavano. We're tied at 2 with 5:02 to play in the first half.
Well, the defensive adjustment that Shaq made there is that they're still going to help the 2 meters and try to neutralize Vanguard down there. They also were showing a press up onto Moulton, but they got to figure Vanguard's got more than one shooter, and Cavano is ready to prove them all wrong.
Nice shot there from the perimeter. Puts it into the corner. And a couple of sweet shots here to start off the second quarter in this 14U final. Entry pass inside. Quick turn and score it.
How about
it? Big time move from Emerson Sullivan. Took his defender for a ride, waited for the keeper to come out and put it into the corner for a 3-2 lead.
That was a heck of a display of leg strength there by Sullivan. Like you said, he had the defender draped on his back, is able to wheel all the way around, defender still on his back, and beat the keeper, Hodge. So in the first quarter, where we get a total of 2 goals, now we've got, what, 3 in the matter of 3 minutes?
Yeah, certainly has picked up here in the scoring department. 4:24 to go here in the first half, and another one. And Cavano just wasting no time, picks it up and just chucks it home from the outside, tied at 3, his second straight goal.
Well, the nerves have clearly worn off, and now these boys are ready to play some water polo. Cavano has established himself as maybe the guy you want to press on the perimeter, but even with a pressing defender, he's able to step away and finish.
Sleepy Hollow tries an outside skip on the attempt there from Spencer Hansen, but it's saved out by Hodge. It'll come back in at 2 meters.
Fresh Good isolation here on the one post, or on the two post, rather.
Going back into Sullivan, but the double team is there, and this time Vanguard was ready. They came with the double team and the ball under. Good adjustment there from Vanguard from last time down. Under four to play in the first half. We're tied at three in this 14U championship. Outside attempt there from Moulton. Sails over the goal, out of play. And it'll come back in. And now Sleepy Hollow takes over. 3:30 to go in the first half.
Now, I don't know if it's fatigue or if it's part of a designed offense, but a lot of the Shaq kids are a little slow to get down to the front court, but maybe this is why.
Ordinary called. Let's not forget, you know, obviously younger kids in relatively good shape, but this Jails is a grind to get through to this, to this title match. You play a lot of games. And there's a knockaway. You know, in some cases you lose a game, you've got to backdoor your way in, you add on some more games. There's an exclusion now in transition. That'll go against Moynihan. His first, now a 6-on-5.
Yeah, Moynihan just got tangled up in the transition there. Easy exclusion for the official to call.
Here's a chance. Sides coming even. Couple of fakes and fired into the corner for Ashworth Moulton. His second. Just a rocket into the corner, and now a 4-3 lead for Vanguard with 2:38 to play in the first half.
Not only does Moulton have a cannon, but his release is really tricky. You can tell by both field player and goalkeeper alike. They can't tell when it's coming off of his hand, and not to mention he's pretty darn accurate.
The left-handers give a different look. Tough to stop there. But also, it has a little tricky release, as you mentioned. I believe Moulton was just named to the men's cadet national team that'll be heading over to Europe for a training trip coming soon.
Here's a good after goal play here by Shaq.
Not so much bounce in that pass. Tricky attempt there from Sullivan.
I'm telling you, they must have seen something out of Noah Hodge that makes Shaq think he's susceptible to a lob. And yeah, they beat him twice on it, but they've gone to that well five or six times at this point, and it's been empty since the first two.
Could be setting us up for a second half of nothing but hard shots. Under two to play here in the second quarter, a 4-3 lead for Vanguard. Outside attempt there is deflected, but it'll stay with Vanguard. And a new shot clock after the field block.
Now clearly Vanguard is comfortable with the depth of their bench. They just went 6-for-6, so you've got six fresh guys out there against perhaps a lagging Shaq team. I'm not sure, but I would imagine this pays dividends towards the fourth quarter.
On the perimeter now, a couple of fakes. Firing, that one's over the goal in the attempt by Kyle Christ. And here's Shaq. 1:22 to go in the first half. Sleepy Hollow trailing 4-3. It's been close throughout. Trying to go inside. Shovel shot
it.
And score it. Just picked it up and scooped it home. Wyatt Hansen, he's tied the game of four. Hodge came out to try and intercept that one and found the ball behind him.
And I'm not positive, but I'm pretty sure Hansen is a righty. And he just swept that ball home with his offhand. If that's the case, that's pretty darn impressive.
Much needed goal there for Sleepy Hollow to make sure they keep this one close. We're tied at four. 1 minute remaining. We've lucked out here. All of our games have been close ones on this Championship Tuesday.
We couldn't ask for more on a championship day, could we?
Here's Vanguard on the attack under a minute to go. Outside attempt, that one off the crossbar and now out of play. It'll come back into Sleepy Hollow. All tied at four. Big stop. Hodge stuffs that one back. And then it goes the other way.
Explosive save there by Hodge. Just jumping out of his suit to get that ball.
Sullivan in close. Hodge would have none of it. And Vanguard takes over. About a four-second differential between the shot and game clock. 24 seconds to play here in the first half. Spinning backhand delivery. And that one's pulled down by Roland. And now last chance here. Sleepy Hollow can try and go for the final shot. Just 10 seconds remaining. Shot clock is off. They come down to the near side here to Sullivan. Just 3 seconds left. See if they get a shot from deep. 1 second left. And it goes off the bar and out of play. And we come to the end of the first half. Sleepy Hollow Aquatics Vanguard 14U Championship all tied at four. We're back after this with the third. Stay with us here from Stanford on CoachesAid.com. Second half about to begin here from Stanford. 2014 Junior Olympics. This is our 14U gold medal match in the championship tournament platinum division. And it's a 4-4 game between Sleepy Hollow Aquatics and Vanguard. And Sleepy Hollow in the light blue caps, which you don't see all that often at water polo.
No, not very often at all.
Bringing that North Carolina UCLA look out here. And it's Vanguard in the white, and that's Noah Hodge, the keeper, controlling.
How about that fancy move there by Wyatt Hansen, though, kicking the ball to himself to redirect.
Now here's Vanguard on the attack. Teams have switched ends. Entry inside, and an exclusion called. This one will go against Vanguard.
It's Woodhead second. The exclusion goes against Shaq there.
Excuse me, yep. That was against Sleepy Hollow.
And this is where Vanguard is really good. They've got two big arm threats on the perimeter, and neither of them were used.
And so Sleepy Hollow able to close off that opportunity, and they get the ball back. About a minute gone by here in the third. It's a 4-4 game.
Good fronting defense there by Simpson.
And here's Hodge controlling. Long outlet pass. Almost too much on that. As they get it ahead now to Cavano. Here's Moulton. Skip shot almost went in off the post. A fight for the ball. And it'll stay with Sleepy Hollow. Good defense there, able to gather that one up as Roland pursued the ball.
Yeah, Roland is struggling against Moulton's release there. And you can see the only thing that wasn't beaten on that particular shot was the post. That's the third time that Moulton has had a good look at the goal and he's either missed or just barred out.
There's a pass to no one in particular. It's taken away. And here's Watson for Vanguard, able to control this one. 4:35 to play in the third. Ball comes near side. Wheeling inside, a couple of turns, different directions on the attempt there by Matthew Kasura. And now a long outlet pass. That one went over the goal. And Sleepy Hollow will try and ignite their offense with Woodhead. Pass over the top, goes to the far side, and too much on that one. And now Noah Hodge will come up with it. Under four to go in the third. We're tied at four in this 14U first place match. Here's a look on the near side. Lob attempt, that one's in. So after Sleepy Hollow going to the lob repeatedly, it's Vanguard converting. Matthew Kasura there with that lob attempt over the head of Roland, and it's a 5-4 lead for Vanguard.
That was a heck of a stretch there for Kasura, because he played 2-2 on the last four possessions going up and down and still had enough gas to put that lob teardrop up and over Roland's head.
And Vanguard goes ahead by one.
Is this their first lead?
I think it might be. It's been back and forth action here. Teams have been close throughout. Sleepy Hollow throws that pass ahead.
I like that backdoor pick they ran there.
Shot clock to 8. Ordinary called. Out on the perimeter.
Good look here.
Big field block, though. Nicely done there. Moulton getting a hand on that one.
I think Moss would have given himself a better opportunity there had he just caught the ball and shot it right away, but the one little wave above his head gave the defense enough time to adjust, and Moulton skied out of the water to get that field block.
And right now for Sleepy Hollow, Michael Dacus out of the game. You can see him behind the bench being attended to by the trainers. Looks like he has an ice pack over his eye as that shot attempt goes off the post and is gathered up by Sleepy Hollow. That's the 16th shot taken by Vanguard on goal. Here's Sleepy Hollow on the attack. 2:36 to go here in the third. 5-4 Vanguard. That attempt is wide right of the goal.
Well, I would imagine there that Hansen would want that one back immediately. He had Noah Hodge creeping all the way to the goalie's right. Near side was open for him. He shot it just wide.
And now a couple of players headed the other way. Sleepy Hollow trying to ignite their offense, but not before Ashworth Moulton just throws another laser into the corner for his third goal and a 6-4 lead for Vanguard, their largest lead of the day.
Yeah, Moulton was clearly trying to set himself up for a foul outside of 5 meters, but this is the second time in the ball game where he tried that. It didn't work out, so he said, all right, I'll just do it on my own.
Big delivery from the left-hander. Able to put that one away. Entry inside now. Sleepy Hollow down 2, looking to rebound. Big turn, but a big save by Hodge. Tried a hook shot there of sorts, did Wyatt Hansen.
Yeah. He showed us the lefty sweep shot earlier. That was the righty.
1:37 to go in the third. A 6-4 lead for Vanguard. In danger of pulling away in this one with that pass. A bad one, and Woodhead comes over to take it away. Gets it back to Roland.
It really has been all Vanguard here in the third quarter. The two goals is a pretty big separation thus far. And now Shaq just really burning some clock and trying to use possession.
Just 1:09 left in the third. It's been a quick period. Not a lot of scoring, and to your point, not a lot from Sleepy Hollow. As we were tied 4-4 at half, it's been all Vanguard here with 2 goals in this quarter.
Yeah, I'm a little confused about that last offensive possession. Coach Swanson clearly wanted to slow it down, and I'm all right with that, but goalkeeper held the ball for about 21 seconds before an entry pass from 20 meters away.
There's Vanguard now thinking outside shot. Timer's down to 8. 40 seconds to go in the period. A few fakes, they come near side. And that shot attempt over the goal, down to play. On the try by Wyatt Benson. 4 seconds between shot and game clock as Sleepy Hollow takes over with their last possession of the third. Trailing 6-4. On a one-on-one action here, and a big save by Hodge. So you saw there Emerson Sullivan trying to do it himself, and Hodge, wise to it, knocks that down. Shot clock is off, just 10 seconds left. Here comes Vanguard. Cavano controlling, 2 seconds.
Got a big arm, too.
Couple of fakes, and that one bounces off the top of the goal out of play. And we come to the end of the third. All Vanguard in that third period. They take a 6-4 lead. 7 minutes left in this gold medal final. Fourth quarter is on the way. Stay with us here on CoachesAid.com. 7 minutes left in our 14U boys Junior Olympic final, along with Pat Beamer, Greg Meskel here with you. And Coach, a period to forget here for the Sleepy Hollow Aquatics Club. They were tied 4-4 at halftime. They get down 6-4. How do they rebound here in the final 7 minutes to try and salvage this gold medal final?
Well, therein lies the rub, Greg, because, you know, they only went down two goals in that particular quarter. But it really, it turns out to be a lot more than that, because Shaq really was just, I don't want to use the word inept because that's a bit too harsh, but they were really benign on their offensive tries. They weren't forcing or they weren't pressing the issue very much. Now, if they want to come back here in the fourth quarter, they really have to move in transition. Vanguard's done a wonderful job taking away their two-meter opportunity. So if they can't push in transition and find the early option, then it could be a long fourth quarter for them.
And conversely, what is Vanguard doing so well that has allowed them to create a little distance here?
Well, quite frankly, I think the difference in this game has been two guys. First, Ash Moulton, number 10 for Vanguard. He's essentially able to do whatever he wants to do. He's much bigger than some of the guys he's being defended by and is able to step up and away. And they've got a wonderful 1-2 combination with Cavano. He's got a rocket for an arm, and when Shaq has played his particular attention to Moulton, well, there's number 3 wide open, ready to bury another shot.
A little hold up here before the start of the fourth, as you had Sleepy Hollow head coach Matt Swanson over here talking with the officials. Not exactly sure what they're debating.
Well, there was some discussion about a nail check. It was pretty clear on one of the Shaq kids that he had a double fingernail scratch that went about the length of his torso. I can't imagine that's going to feel good.
And I heard the official let Coach Swanson know, you can protest this if you want, I guess in reference to what it is that they're debating. Looks like we're about ready to get things going here.
Clearly both sides are going to be pumped up after hearing the 1987 hit, Salt and Pepper Push It. Nothing says fourth quarter action to me like that.
Especially for a group of athletes that were nowhere near live when that song crushed the radio charts. We're underway here in the fourth, a 6-4 lead for Vanguard. And a knockaway to start things. Sleepy Hollow had the ball taken away from behind. Great defense there from Vanguard.
Now Cavano.
Look at them ahead of the field. Difficult pass to make among three light blue caps. And they were trying to thread the needle there to Cavano. Taken away. And now trying to catch the goalie out of the cage on that long attempt by Roland. Just not enough on that.
Both keepers, I think, would like to take those two passes back. I mean, first of all, Hodge had a streak in Cavano. That probably would have resulted in a goal. And then after he comes off his line, Roland just shorts the shot.
So turnovers leading to turnovers here to start off this fourth quarter.
And so far, I really like the pace out of Shaq. I mean, they certainly came into this fourth quarter way more energized than they did out of the halftime break.
Outside attempt, Hodge there, knocks it down, easy with the right hand. And Vanguard controls. Minute gone by here in the fourth. It's a 6-4 lead for Vanguard. Remember, this is the second of three teams they have in gold medal finals today in the Platinum Division 12, 14, 16U. So we're going to see more Vanguard after this as that one's knocked away.
Great crashing defense there by Woodhead.
Here's Sleepy Hollow now on the move. They have not scored a goal since the first half. Looking to remedy that here, trailing by two. Shot clock under 10. Moynihan looking to work free. Double team comes. Has the ordinary. Puts it up on the skip, and it finds a way home. Much needed goal for Connor Moynihan, his second. And first, since way back in the first quarter, took a trippy hop, tricky hop and a snuck past Noah Hodge.
The old skip lob does the trick. I'll tell you what, Greg, I was just about to say the next goal of this game is going to be critical for all parties involved. Had it have been Vanguard to take the 3-goal lead, that very well could have put Shaq on their heels. But now they've crept back into it. Just a 1-goal ball game at this point. Shaq is very much alive. A little clock malfunction, it looks like.
Pull the ball out here real quick. Crowds starting to fill up here slowly. If you're watching this, and if you're hearing me, you are, you'd see occasionally our shot of the bleachers, it's empty, but that is not indicative of the crowd that is here. That is just where the sun is shining. A lot of people steer clear of those seats until later in the day. They follow the shade here at Avery, so everyone is loaded in behind us here on the other side where it is currently the shady side. And as we get towards the 16 and the 18, you finally see more and more folks start to file in here.
Right. In fact, the shady side that you don't see is currently standing room only. I caught a glimpse of that at the break. Oh, and here's Moulton. Another heavy dose of him.
Looking for that ordinary. See if he steps back and tries to fire. Instead, he goes entry pass and a big scoop shot there on the inside. On the attempt from Vanguard and Wyatt Benson, but that one's off the post, and the rebound to Sleepy Hollow with 4:39 to go in the fourth.
That was a wonderful entry pass there by Moulton. Everybody, myself included, was expecting him to shoot. He was able to drop it down to 2 meters and just got unlucky on the post.
That's an ordinary. On the perimeter, here's Sleepy Hollow. Looking inside. Trying for the backhand, but good defense. Kasora there to snuff out the attempt from Sullivan, who's going to try and go for a backhand. 4:10 to play here in the fourth. 1-goal game, 6-5, Vanguard ahead. In this gold medal final, 14U. Big entry inside. Ball under is the call. Defense is there from Wyatt Hansen. Now here comes Sleepy Hollow.
So far this quarter, it's really been all Shaq controlling. I know they've dodged a couple of bullets, but that last goal clearly has energized them a little bit.
Entry inside, not enough on that one to get to the intended recipient, as two white caps for Vanguard were able to sneak in there and make the steal. 3:30 to play here in the fourth, a 6-5 lead for Vanguard.
There's the 1-2 combo, Kamano and Moulton.
Gavano sets it up to himself. A little self-pass there, but a save made by Roland. And here's Sleepy Hollow. 3:10 to play, so opportunities running out now for both teams as we get down to the final moments of this one in our 14U championship.
We just had a walking yellow card issued to the Vanguard coach. Supposed to be contained within the 5-meter zone, and he was out to a solid 12.
Outside attempt, bar down and in. We're tied at Sleepy Hollow delivering from deep. It's Wyatt Hansen with his third. We're tied at 6, 2:52 to play.
What a beautiful shot there by Wyatt Hansen. First one comes on a lob. Second one comes off of a lefty sweep. And now with the right hand, I'm guessing the dominant hand, just drills it from 8 meters.
And there's that yellow card to the Vanguard coach, who was at mid-tank giving out instructions. He's now retreated back to exactly 5 meters.
No more, no less. Coach Swanson nearly took a dip into the pool there.
He has a more casual approach, going shoeless, standing on the gutter. 2:45 to play here in the game. We're tied at 6. Might sound like a broken record, but again, we have a final here going down to the wire here at 2014 JOs.
Here's Cavano setting himself up for a big one.
He'll take a look. Bangs off the post. Rebound, Sleepy Hollow. And credit this Shaq team coming back. Hadn't scored since the first half. They've mustered up, manufactured 2 goals here in the fourth to get right back in this game.
And it could be 3.
Here's a look. That one, a timing play that was just off the mark. But we're going to stay on this end because it's a contra foul in transition. They were trying to get Sullivan involved. The pass went over his head, but on the way down, he got tangled up with Cavano. The contra foul is called. It'll stay with Sleepy Hollow. They'll get a new shot clock with 2:10 to play in the fourth.
And this could be potentially disastrous here for the Vanguard faithful. Setting up a nice ISO with Moynihan on the three post. There it is.
In it goes, but taken away. And great defense from Vanguard. Garrett Zahn coming over.
Clock goes under 2 minutes.
Less than two to play now in the fourth. Here's a dangerous player for Vanguard. And perhaps more dangerous for Sleepy Hollow, Moulton. He'll take a look.
He's
trying to get some distance with that left hand, or that right hand, rather. Thinking shot, not available. 5 seconds on the timer. Outside attempt, and not much on it on the try from Cavano. So Vanguard now has become relegated to a bit of an outside look here between Cavano and Moulton. Hasn't led to goals lately. They had two in the third. They've been blanked in this fourth quarter. Sleepy Hollow has come back. A minute 18 to play.
Well, and you really have to credit Emerson Sullivan, number eight, for Shaq, who has clearly been assigned to defend on Moulton. On a quick timeout here by Shaq. I mean, time is certainly of a premium. They're going to get the ball back after this possession, probably just one more time, which means with only 9 seconds left on the clock, this is a great time to draw something up and get a goal.
Interesting that, and I think he was trying to call it a little sooner, but only having 9 seconds when you come out of this, so you're going to have to hurry here. 6-6, Shaq and Vanguard all even, 1:11 to go. We're here in the fourth in this 14U gold medal championship. Thanks for joining us here on CoachesAid.com. Don't forget these matches will be available for purchase after they're over. You can access them online or order DVDs.
It's always nice to relive the memories.
Sure, especially if you win. Great finish here on the farm. Stanford University, 6-6. Sleepy Hollow Aquatics, Vanguard, all tied in this 14U championship.
Just 9 seconds to go on this possession for Shaq. I know they want it to result in a shot and certainly ideally a goal. I'm curious to see how it's going to wind its way down.
1:11 to go. To your point, likely another possession out there for Sleepy Hollow. But they use the timeout here and they'll have the opportunity to set something up in the half court. And let's see what Sleepy Hollow can put together coming out of the break.
Well, Wyatt Hansen has been the hot hand for Shaq thus far. He's lined up at the two spot and he's involved in the pick out there. Looks like he's going to try and isolate himself onto the two post.
Here's Moynihan with two on the clock. Wide right out of play. And it comes back to Vanguard. Minute two remaining. And Vanguard getting ready to blow their air horn for a timeout. Perhaps see what develops here. They're going to advance the ball. Under a minute to play now. Winding down here in the fourth. We're tied at six. Vanguard and Sleepy Hollow. Outside attempt. Field block is there. Rebound fought for. And let's see. So this is going to stay with Vanguard. Sleepy Hollow tried to call for time, thinking they had the rebound on that. You heard the air horn. That was from Coach Swanson. The official on the far side ruling that the ball was going to stay with Vanguard. And now you're seeing Coach Swanson inquire with the officials, how is the Vanguard coach all the way near mid-tank? He's already been given a yellow card for coming out too far. But they're going to let him play on. Let the players in the pool decide this one. And now we'll get a timeout from Vanguard. 39 seconds left.
Well, both coaches actually are guilty of infractions there. I would argue that Shaq could have been easily charged with a penalty for calling timeout without the ball. You heard the horn come early. And then again, Vanguard, who has already been warned, in fact carded, for extending themselves beyond the 5-meter line, was on the wrong side of half.
He'll love me for bringing this up, but if you recall the 2012 Olympic Games, when you call a timeout and you don't have possession, that can lead to some issues.
What would Coach K say about this?
Coach McCorian is is up front and saying it's one of his worst mistakes ever, but the moral of the story is you have to have possession before you made that timeout call. USA obviously got out of there just fine in London, but let's see what it comes to here. It didn't result in a penalty for Sleepy Hollow. It's 39 seconds remaining. We're tied 6-6. And the chant for Shaq goes out among the Sleepy Hollow faithful. Vanguard based in Orange County, Sleepy Hollow, a Northern California club.
Well, here's the setup by Vanguard. You got Moulton pretty much isolated by himself. I'm guessing he's going to wrap himself center cage to 5 meters and just try and fire one home to win the game.
What's interesting is Moulton has been using that off arm to try and generate some space, and it hasn't been a problem just yet. He goes inside on the entry, looking to turn, quick shot, and score! Vanguard's ahead! Score it for number 7, Matthew Kasora. It's a 7-6 lead for Vanguard, and now a yellow card here for Sleepy Hollow coach Matt Swanson, but Vanguard goes ahead. Their first goal of the fourth comes with 28 seconds left, and now it'll be up to Sleepy Hollow, who calls for time, their final timeout, to draw something up in the final 28 seconds.
Well, I'll tell you what, Greg, you absolutely hit the nail on the head when you mentioned that Moulton was using his right arm to earn space. In fact, did so, in my opinion, egregiously on that last possession, was allowed to get away with it. Clearly, Swanson is upset. I think he's got a legitimate qualm there. But now, it's done. The play is done. Timeout has been taken. And this is the last breath here for Shaq. If they can't come up with a big goal here, International is going to go 2-for-2 so far on their championships. Check that, Vanguard.
Vanguard. International, though, was happy for the shout-out. 7-6, Vanguard ahead here. 28 seconds left. Shot clock is off, so Sleepy Hollow can run this down. In this situation, you're out of timeouts, the shot clock is off. Do you run it and look for the very best shot, or do you try and go a little early and see if you can generate a second chance?
I absolutely. You take the first best available shot. So if that opens up with 1 or 2 seconds in out of this timeout, go ahead and take the shot, because you're absolutely right. Secondary shot options can become available, and beggars can't be choosers at this point.
Out of the timeout. Back and forth action here in this one. Sleepy Hollow led first, 1-0. Since then, they've gone back and forth. Vanguard went ahead 6-4 at the end of three. We were tied 4-4 at halftime. 6-4, end of three. Sleepy Hollow battles back to tie this thing at 6, and then Vanguard scores just moments ago to go ahead at 7-6. And now the onus here on Sleepy Hollow. Let's see what they have in this 14U championship final.
Double post option here.
Keep it on the perimeter. Remember, shot clock is off. We're down to 15 in the game. Great look inside. Oh. Just off the mark. They had the opportunity. The goal wasn't where Sullivan thought it would be. He shot it out of play. And Vanguard is in a great spot right now with 9 seconds to play. Well, that was dangerous right there. A pass back to the keeper. And a near steal. And now a penalty is called.
Unbelievable turn of events.
What a turn of events. A timeout was given on the near side. That ball was up for grabs, going back to goalkeeper Noah Hodge. The air horn sounded, and the official on the far side called a penalty. And this is going to lead to a shot attempt for Sleepy Hollow and a chance to tie this game with just 6 seconds remaining.
Unbelievable.
One official seemed to overrule the other.
Absolutely. He came from the backcourt, overruled his partner. I think it's the right call, but just a tough call to be made.
Here we go. Score it! We're tied! Shaq has even things with just 6 seconds left. That's Wyatt Hansen, his fourth. Tying this game at 7. In an unbelievable finish in this 14U final. Just 6 seconds left. Let's see what Vanguard has. Is there more drama to be had in these final 6 seconds? It wouldn't surprise me. Keep an eye on Moulton. Outside attempt, skip. Save is made. One last chance, off the mark.
I thought that was it.
That comes to the end of regulation. We're headed to a shootout. Vanguard and Sleepy Hollow to decide the 14U championship. What a finish here at Stanford. We'll take a quick timeout and return with the shootout. Stay with us on CoachesAid.com. Welcome back. We're headed to a shootout here. 7-7 tied after regulation. Sleepy Hollow and Vanguard. And now we go to a shootout. If you're unfamiliar, five shooters aside. Who's ever made the most after those is your winner. If you remain tied after that, you go one for one until someone makes, someone misses.
High drama for a championship game.
And the captains for each side, Moulton for Vanguard and Wyatt Hansen, who put away that penalty shot with just seconds remaining to force the shootout. Come to meet with the officials. And looks like they're going to flip a coin here to determine who will go first. And into the gutter it goes, but they can still figure it out. High intensity, high drama here to decide a gold medal and a championship. And for obviously a group of high-level athletes that are going to keep on playing this game, a great opportunity to be part of a high-stakes finish.
Yeah, I mean, this is just building great experience and great character for both these squads. It's been a battle. Clearly these two teams are worthy opponents, worthy enough to be in the championship, and now it comes down to this. Can you finish a penalty? Can you do it five times? Shooters have to be calm under pressure. The goalies have to be huge.
So Vanguard is going to start things off with Moulton. Thought they might have saved him for the closer spot.
I would have thought
first.
So too.
Yeah.
But I guess they want to get off on the right track. You know, there's a lot of discussion on have your best guy shoot first or last. In this case, Vanguard's going to have him go first and hopefully put them ahead 1-0. All pressure goes to Shaq if he scores.
So here's the left-hander, Moulton up first. Bar down and in on the bounce, puts it away. And now it comes to Sleepy Hollow, and they'll go to their captain, Wyatt Hansen. So both teams leading with some of their better shooters.
Well, I suppose that makes some sense. If there's an early save or an early miss, you might not get to your best shooters. Why not put them up front, let them have their run at it, and see where the rest play out.
Here's Hansen.
Hodge is baiting him.
He puts it away. Hodge guessed the other way. Hansen connects, so we're even here 1-1 in the shootout, 8-8 overall. And now for Vanguard, Jacob Cavano. He had two goals in regulation. He puts it away.
No bow to doubt it.
Cavano connecting. And now Spencer Hansen will come on for Sleepy Hollow.
This is one of these things, Greg. It's who's going to make the mistake? You know, statistically speaking, penalty shots from 5 meters are good about 80 to 85% of the time. There's certainly margin for error in there. And this is really time for a goalie to shine.
Here's Hansen. Scores it. Snuck it into that corner. Hodge guessed correctly, but couldn't pick it up.
Yeah, I thought Hodge was all over that. It just crept underneath his outstretched arm.
And now here's Warren Loth, someone we didn't call his name a lot during the match, but he'll come on to take it for the third round. A save! Stopped by Roland.
It's not over yet, though. There's still more shooters to go. But boy, is that a huge stop by Roland.
No, Onus still on Sleepy Hollow here. Here's Quinn Woodhead. They have got to, obviously, continue to find a way to put the ball in the back of the net. But now the pressure here on Hodge. Score it! Sleepy Hollow, 3-for-3 as Woodhead puts that one away. And now here's Wyatt Benson.
A stop will end it here. The game is on the line on this shot. Am I wrong there?
I think we... Sleepy Hollow will need to make one more.
Got it.
Here's the attempt, and they score it. We move on.
Quiet Benson scores. Vanguard 3,
3-3 right now, 10-10 overall.
The fourth shooter now for Shaq.
Henry Moss for Sleepy Hollow.
Hodge has been guessing right every single time, just fractionally off.
Got it that time. Hodge was due for a block. He comes up with it. And we have come to the fifth and final round of shooters right where we started, even. Each side has made three. Each side has stopped once. And here is Matthew Kasouris, scored a huge goal down the end of regulation. It was the one that put Vanguard ahead momentarily. Will he do the same here? Off the post! He missed it!
Shaq can win it with a make here. Vanguard preserves their life to single round.
Here's Moynihan. A make here, and you're going to see the guys in light blue erupt. Here's Moynihan for the win and the 14U gold medal. Save!
Unbelievable. We go to one-on-one. Yes, my eardrums might be blown out, but I want more.
Unreal finish. Stops on the fifth round. And now you rotate it back around, so the order can stay the same, but you go one for one here. And here's Moulton. And it's back to Moulton versus Hansen.
So it's one for one all the way out, right?
And here's Moulton. Made his first.
Made his first, and Hodge wasn't even close to it.
Another Roland.
Excuse me. Wrong team.
And he puts another one away. Moulton connects. And now huge pressure here on Wyatt Hansen. Crazy how these shootouts work. It was just in the control of Sleepy Hollow, and now they are under the gun to put one away here, or it's a championship for Vanguard.
And you can feel the tension in the arena here.
Hansen to prolong things. Scores it. We go on. So through six shooters, we're even. We come back now. Here's Cavano. He scores.
And back around we go.
The onus back on Sleepy Hollow. Here's Spencer Hansen. Scored his last time. Hansen to keep the game going. A stop, and Vanguard wins it. That's the game! Vanguard wins it! Your 14 and under Junior Olympic Championships go to Vanguard. Everyone into the water, a dramatic finish. An instant classic here.
Yeah, absolutely instant classic. That was a game that could have gone either way. Nothing between them through regulation. Had to go to shootouts. And boy, the saves from both keepers really were the difference. What an exciting way to earn a championship.
Credit Noah Hodge. He makes the stop there at the end. The resiliency of this Vanguard team. I'll tell you what, a couple of times, Coach, all seemed lost there for them, especially in that shootout when it comes down to the final shooter of regulation. Sleepy Hollow has to put it away, and they win it. They get a stop there, and it continues on. And here we are now with another title, two straight gold medals here for the Vanguard Club.
Yeah, if they make a clean sweep 3-for-3, that's wholly impressive. But it's not like they haven't been challenged throughout. Both our championship games, both in the 12 and 14 divisions, could have gone either way. But boy, the sun is certainly shining for Vanguard.
So our 16U final coming up soon, our medal presentation coming up sooner than that for the 14 and under division. So we're going to step aside here, but hang around for the 14U medal presentation, and then we'll join you back here poolside for the 16U final. Stay with us here on CoachesAid.com.